Yeah, Cheryl, you talked quite a bit yesterday about how important Alanna Smith was to her, to this team. Her defense tonight, particularly the defense on that next to last possession against Stewart, that kind of illustrate what you were talking about?
For sure, all season long. You know, Lan's been in those positions for us, and you know, just appreciate her ability to turn around and buck up and do what her team needed her to do. And like you said, she's important. Important for her to be on the floor for us.
Next question, first row to your right.
Hey, Cheryl.
Hey.
Can you, what did you kind of call on that final possession to kind of put the ball in Courtney's hands and seem like let her make a decision? And also, kind of, what was the message also that you, in that situation, the last kind of words you sent them out there with?
Well, I thought it was obvious what we were trying to do. You know, we went four flat and said, Court, you know, make a play. And the last thing we said was we got to get the last shot. We didn't want to shoot too early. We want to make sure we get the last shot. And then we said, BC, if you have a chance, follow it up and see if you can tip one in and get fouled. That's exactly how we drew it up.
Next question, next two questions, front row to your left.
Cheryl, first of all, I want to know how you've coached here so long with that type of crowd and not gone deaf yet.
Yeah.
This game was just incredible. So many ties, so many lead changes. Now we get a decisive game five. And I wondered, you've talked a lot the last few days about that the W is finally, people are finally investing. Do you feel like this finals is a good example of like what you get when you put money into your teams?
For sure, for sure. And I think as a league, you know, kind of getting it and our TV partner, you know, being a partner in the best of ways at this time and all of it, all of the investments. And then I think the players deserve all the credit for the show that we're being treated to. And I thought both teams, you know, played well. It was a good game. You know, it was not, I mean, obviously both teams, you know, you have things you can point to that, you know, you wish you make a layup or you wish you didn't do this or that. And that's what a game always is. But yeah, no, I'm looking forward to seeing what the ratings are for this one.
Front row to your left once again.
For the players, Fee, what do you think you're able to do to like speed up Stewie today? And for K-Mac, how were you able to keep Sabrina off the 3-point line so successfully?
I think the same defense as always. You try to make it as hard as possible for them to get the shots that they want. They're good players. They're going to get shots off, but they can't get easy ones. So that's my goal every time, is to make it as hard as I can.
Yeah, same. I mean, this is the fourth time we're playing them. We both know each other so well. We know each other's tendencies. And so it's just making everything hard, you know. And I think that's the name of the game on both sides right now.
Next question, second row center.
I'd like to ask this of both coach and either of the players. You all know what Bridget has done for this team for years, often not stuff that showed up in a stat sheet. How cool is it to see her be the person in this situation making that play and sending you back to New York?
Well, I think it's the epitome of the year she's had and how important she's been to this team and shot making, you know, big three, and then obviously she's a hustle play player. You know, so that was on display. You know, give yourself a chance to, you know, maybe put it in or get fouled. So that's just what she does every day. We're around her. She's the same. You know, you can always count on her to be there for you. You know, we're obviously super proud of Bridget.
Yeah, same. I completely agree. I feel like Bridget is just so reliable every time. And like Coach said, we can, you know, bank on her to make those hustle plays and to be cool and collected at the end to make those free throws. That's the hardest shot in basketball, honestly, is free throws at the end of the game. Mm-hmm. And to knock those down at the big moment is just exactly who BC is. They're saying Nas free tattoos. I think BC free tattoos is next.
Next question, second row, center right.
Hey, Coach.
Hey, Tim.
Just wanted to, this is a little bit of a follow-up on Lindsay's question, but just want to give you a chance to shout out the establishment that's on your T-shirt for tonight. obviously, you know, that a bar of their own is something that was influenced by kind of the investments that have been made in women's sports. And I talked to a number of other business owners, bartenders in the area this week who had viewing parties with audio on and filled up within, you know, just minutes and had to, you know, take, you know, waiting lists. And I wasn't attending those bars in 2017, so I wouldn't know, but I think that's something that might be a little bit different this time around.
I think you hit the nail on the head. It's unfortunate because those teams were obviously really a joy to watch, but it's just a sign of the times where we are now. You know, I don't know about these guys, but I know when I'm out and I'm in different places that I'm going to, one, everyone's talking about it. Everyone's talking to me about it, talking about I go to this bar, and this is a bar that maybe wouldn't have a women's game on 5 years ago. all the games, or all the TVs have the game on, and the volume on, and the place going crazy. I heard that so many times in different establishments, and obviously I appreciate the opportunity that a bar of their own has given women and making that front and center, and I'm happy to support women-owned business like that. And I just think that what this team has done, obviously the Wolves energized the city in their playoff run. I'm thrilled to see that same energy came for this team because they deserve it. Obviously the crowd that was there tonight, but even more than that, when everywhere you go around the city, people are talking about the Lynx.
All right, we do have a lot of hands raised here in the room, so be patient. We'll get to as many of you as we can. Next question will come from the third row to your left.
Yeah, if I could ask this of Fee and then one for Coach. Fee, the battle between you and Brianna Stewart has been pretty intense. It was a little tough to get shots for either one of you or making shots. Can you just talk about how tough that battle's been? And then, Coach, you have been through several five-game finals in your career. Can you just talk about what it means to do it one more time?
Yeah, it's really tough. I mean, I think that we're both great players, and it was game four, and we played each other, four times in the regular season. It's going to get harder and harder each time to get those shots that you normally get. So everyone's out there to do the same thing, make shots hard. And, you know, that's my goal every time is she's a great player, one of the best players in the world. You have to make it as hard as you can for her.
Next question.
I'm going to answer Michael's the second part, the game five. I don't really think about the other ones. I do feel, you know, very, very blessed, you know, in my career to have a chance to, you know, have been a part of so many. Haven't won them all. You know, when I was in Detroit, you know, we suffered a heartbreak at home. You know, so it runs the gamut. And I think that what I'm just thrilled about is that this group gets to experience the game five. I mean, it's beyond words how we feel about this team. And we just so wanted them to be in the finals, number one, and two, put themselves in position to win a championship, and we've done just that.
Next question, second row all the way to the right.
Yeah, Cheryl, Sandy was in here and said that she thought your complaints about the officiating led to a favorable whistle for your team. She said it was not fair, and she was pissed off, and she used another word I'm not going to use, and this might be your last chance to comment on that topic before game five. Do you have any response to that?
I didn't get a response from the league. I have a text to prove it. You know, I think that, I think Fee has some things to, you know, to prove that the fouls weren't called. That's unfortunate. You know, I guess I don't really have much more than that.
Next question, front row left.
Down here, Cheryl.
Yep.
Just what will be the difference in game five?
I wish I knew. I'd either not sleep or I'd sleep really good if I knew the difference, right? It's two great teams. Who knows? Who knows?
Next question, standing all the way in the back left.
Hey, Coach. This question is one's for Kayla and one's for Fee. Kayla, for you, very efficient game from you to start. When you're feeling it like that, how do you know? Is there something before that you kind of get into a rhythm that you know that you're going to have like that kind of a shooting night? And Fee, for you, post game, I saw that you had an embrace with Lindsay. Just kind of curious to know what that was about. Was there any words of wisdom or advice or what that conversation was?
For me, I just wanted to come out and enjoy the moment and be as aggressive as possible. You know, when you're playing for your season, you know, after the last game, you sit with everything, and then you kind of erase it, and you just kind of want to leave all those internal feelings and put them out there, you know, and embrace the crowd. And I just wanted to be out there with my teammates and give it everything we had, you know, like shots go in, they don't go in, whatever. There's always things you can fix or whatever. But I just was excited to be out there, excited to compete again after the last game. And, you know, shots were falling, and that's always a good time.
Next question, third row center.
I think there was a Fee.
We were celebrating together, and she was saying how proud she is of us and the team, and I was telling her that she has to get her butt to New York.
Third row center.
Cheryl, you talked last year about a rebuild, and now you're going to game five of the WNBA Finals. How did tonight's performance embody the grit that this team has?
Yeah, I mean, anybody that's following along knows that this team from the beginning of the season all the way through to game four has this unique ability to believe in themselves and believe in each other. And what we said before the game, you know, can we do it in the toughest of times, right? Because this will be the most that we're tested. We talked about it in shoot around. This will be the most that this group's been tested in that way. I was sure how we would connect and compete. I'm not sure whether you're going to win the game or not, but I was sure that we were going to be the Minnesota Lynx and how we've done things all season long. You know, the ups and downs and all of that, this group is just equipped to handle it. I mean, it's special.
All right, we have time for just a few more from the room. Second row center.
Hey, congratulations, you guys. Cheryl, for you with Alanna Smith, I'm just wondering, were you surprised, expected that you were able to get that 30-plus minutes from her? Was there, you know, sort of a see-how-it-goes situation? And then just also what she was able to do when she was out there. Yeah. Just take me through
it
that.
It was expected. I think, you know, going into the game, we talked about it in the pregame, that we were going into the game as if, you know, that didn't happen. And whatever was going to show itself was going to show itself, and we would react. But we didn't have any minute restrictions. We didn't have anything else that we were doing to modify and just competed. We did try to get some players off the floor a little bit more. Not this one. We weren't able to get it. We thought about it. But I think overall, you know, I was concerned about leaving Land too long on the bench, you know, sitting too long. But other than that, you know, we weren't concerned.
Hold on. Next question will come from third row all the way to the left.
Cheryl, when you think back to the 2017 roster and bringing Chechi back this season, what did you see out of her tonight and that trust to get big minutes off the bench?
Yeah, I mean, Chechi's tough. You know, goes through a stretch of games where maybe she's not contributing like she wants to contribute. And then all of a sudden we had a Chechi sighting at shoot around the other day. Mm-hmm. And these last two games, you know, really helping us. And you know, I mean, I'm just happy for her. You know, we've always stayed in touch through the years. You know, we've always tried to get her back here, and the timing was good for this one, and she's been a great fit for us.
Ooh. Next two questions will come from the center, second row.
For Fee, I want to know, it was reported that Gino said he hoped Brianna got 50 tonight. I was just wondering, between the two of you having his players in this series, how's he handling that? Who's he rooting for? What's happening?
Well, it sounds like he's rooting for them. He didn't text that to me.
Oh, I love it.
Like some husky drama.
I love it, drama.
Go Irish.
Looks like I'm going to have to text him about some things now.
And then, Cheryl, I wanted to just know, how did you feel about your bench tonight? T injures her finger. She comes in. Dorka comes in. Yeah. Chechi comes in. It seemed like they all made impact plays and did things that really helped the team
bench
tonight.
Bench was really important. We knew they were going to be. They were ready. They were ready. There was a lot of conversations, you know, the teammates, getting them going, getting them ready, you know, to be able to make contributions when they got in the game. Give Dorka credit as she remained patient, you know, and when she got the opportunity, I thought her minutes were good. We'll look at the video and, you know, but it was nice to be able to, you know, have players able to sub and even stay out there for an extended time.
All right, these will be our last two questions. Second row, center left.
This is for any of you that want to answer. Every single game has come down to it. There has been no mental break, no physical break, but you seem to gain energy from that. Is there some sort of sharpness that you've earned in terms of an edge that way as a team, getting down to the nitty-gritty each and every single game?
Is that why we miss layups, so we can get down to the nitty-gritty? I don't know. Is that what you're saying?
But you got to have mental toughness, though.
No, right? I'd like to know that, so I can be okay.
I know, right?
For the ratings,
that's what it is. My heart is still racing. But I think it's just we gain energy and confidence from one another. Like, internally, I feel like we're very strong, strong-minded, mentally, physically. We have a lot of belief within our group, you know? We problem-solve with each other, and it's just a belief, like, internally. I don't know how else to explain it. So when things get hard, we kind of come together even more. And when things get tough, that's what's been able to see us through. And so when, you know, in these moments, that's what you need. You know, everybody's tired. Everybody, you know, we're playing every other day now. So we're leaning on each other and we gain energy from each other. That's why our bench was so important today, you know, and we've been doing it as a collective from, you know, our coaches, you know, the staff, everybody. We're all in this together, and you can feel that every time we're together. So I think that's what you see on the court, is just us figuring out together and going to war together.
All the way to the right in the back.
First, congrats on pushing to a game five. This is a question for any or all of you. Stewie talked about yesterday how she actually likes playing in front of a crowd that's not cheering for her. What is it like to go back to New York for final game
for the final game? Do you feel like that you play better in front of a home crowd, or how do you turn that off when you go to New York?
I think we're excited. I mean, I don't even know if I'm thinking about that. I'm thinking that it's a game five of the finals mm-hmm. that we need to go out and execute. And that's really all I'm thinking about.
Yeah, last 40 minutes of the season. Like, that's it could be anywhere, really. Yeah. It doesn't matter. It's like we're going to be out there together and going to war, and I'm pumped.
Many elite players play no matter the environment, home, road, right? The elite players play, and they love the environment, and they're not affected by the environment. And that's why you see this series has been what it has, winning on each other's court.
This will be our last question, front row left.
There were really big leads in the first halves of the first three games. I'm just wondering why you think it was so hard for either team to create any separation today.
I'm going to say probably information gathered in the three games. Everything's getting harder. Yeah. Yeah. So the edge, you know, that maybe other games that provided each team, it was, you know, there's no secrets at this point. Thanks, everybody.
Nafisa, Kayla, Cheryl, thank you. Yep.